Good morning.
Good morning, Tom.
Welcome, everyone, to service here this morning. The sun shines brightly upon all, and our eyes are twinkling because of all this new life in front of us here. So I met people from Delafield, people that are transplanted from Chicago. Anybody else from out of town? From where? New York? California? Where?
Sacramento.
Oh, northern. Okay. That's okay. I like the northern half of the state. Anybody else?
Madison.
Okay. So we are united around the table of the Lord. And we have these couples in front of us here, and I'll ask them to raise their hands. Jeremy and Marlene. Nacek?
Nosek.
And Eric and Amanda Shad. And Christopher and Renee Spielbauer. Okay. Now, you're all here for a reason. I presume I know what that reason is, but what do you ask of God's church for these?
Baptism.
You've asked to have your children baptized. In doing so, you accept the responsibility of training them in the practice of our faith. And they are touched by the divine already. See that it's kept safe, always. Godparents. Let's go through this again. Amy and Catherine over here, right? Amy and Catherine?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Okay. Raise your hand so I know who you are, okay? Joseph and Dawn. There they are. Okay. And David and Sarah. Okay. Are you ready to help these parents in their duty as Christian parents?
Yes.
Okay. Let's begin over here. What name do you give to your daughter to be baptized with?
Liliana Ann.
Liliana Ann. What name do you give to your daughter to be baptized with? Charlotte Ruth. And Charlotte Ruth is a first-timer. The others are have been around the block with this. Charlotte Ruth. And big brother? This is to be who?
Braden
Michael. The Christian community of St. James here welcomes all this new life among us. And I invite you as a congregation, as we do at every service, to place the cross upon yourself and recommit yourself in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And that's it for now. You can go back to your places, and after the gospel and a few words, we'll do the baptisms.
Thank you.
We ask you, O God, Jesus, send the Holy Spirit upon the water of this fount, that those buried with Christ in death and baptism would rise with him to the newness of life. We ask and pray, amen. Parents and godparents, you come here to have your children baptized, to receive the gift of new life. On your parts, you must make it your constant care to bring them up in this faith of ours. See that the divine life is kept to grow stronger in their hearts. I invite you and the assembly to join in the rejection of what is wrong and the profession of what is faith. And so I ask you, is it Charlotte Ruth?
Yes.
Liliana Ann?
Yes.
Braden Michael? Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be conquered by sin? Do you reject that source of sin, Satan, and prince of darkness? And I ask you for these children, do you believe in God the Almighty, the creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus, his son, who was born of Virgin Mary, crucified, died, and buried, rose from death, and is with God at the right hand? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit? Do you believe in our church? Do you believe in the communion of saints? Do you believe in forgiveness of sin and resurrection and life everlasting? Let's see, who will we take first? Charlotte Ruth, you're a firstborn, right? Come on up, you'll go first then. Is it your will that Charlotte Ruth be baptized in the faith of the church which we have professed?
It is.
Hold her head over the fount. God, Father, put your hand on her. Charlotte Ruth, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Is it your will that Liliana Ann be baptized in this faith?
Yes.
Liliana Ann, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Sure you want to do this with Braden?
For sure.
Is it your will that we baptize Braden Michael?
Yes.
Braden Michael, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. From this place of entrance, then, let us go again to the front for the christening and the receiving of the light. Now, I know this is a special dress constructed from two wedding gowns, okay? I don't know the history of the other gowns, but I would ask the Godfathers to place the stoles upon these children. Godmother, excuse me. He doesn't wear one every day. He doesn't know what he's doing. Children, you are now part of God's creation. You are clothed in these stoles, outward sign of your Christian dignity. Now, with your families and friends, bring the dignity unstained to the everlasting. Amen. Christ was anointed himself, a priest, a prophet, and a king. May you live as a member of his life forever. I don't have the touch today. We've been with the water and new life, been with the oil and the christening. Now it is the light of the risen Jesus that we would give these children. We've got the candle already. Brought your own?
We just have a box.
Oh, just, yeah. just a box.
I thought the same thing. From like...
Godmother, take one. Show it to the baby. Maybe she won't cry. I say to you, parents and godparents, on behalf of these children, receive the light of Christ. This light, this life, is given you to be kept burning brightly. These are to be children of the light, and they are to walk to the Lord and keep the flame alive and in their hearts written, until the Lord is ready to receive them in the heavens. Amen. Thank you, all of you. You can go back to your place, because now we're going to pray for these children.